Hello and welcome. I'm Anupama Dwivedi and I'm a consulting editor with CFO India. In association with Oracle, CFO India is launching a series that brings into sharp focus the critical quality of agility. The crisis brought about by the COVID-19 pandemic has completely redefined the way we look at work, and companies that have taken the lead in adopting agile transformation have fared better than others who were less prepared. To discuss this, we have with us today Jatinder Lal, Chief Financial Officer of Wipro Limited. Welcome, Jatin, and thank you for sparing the time to speak with us.
Thank you, Anupama. Thank you very much for having me here. Thank you.
So, first up, Jatin, how would you define business agility within the context of the last year and a half, you know, since the pandemic hit?
I think the concept of business agility has never been tested as intensely as it has been tested in last 18 months. I think we had a very location-specific view of response to a crisis, response to environment, response to customer needs. And almost overnight, we realized as an industry, as a corporate world, that if you need to change, you need to change quickly, and you may need to change everywhere in all locations in the world and in all parts and in all parts of your operations, right from supply chain to recruitment, to finance, to HR, to delivery, and so on and so forth. So I think if the change is the biggest theme for last 18 months, the best response to that, the companies that they have been able to give are the companies that have been the most agile in their thinking, in their process, in their systems. And therefore, I think agility has been the core theme in the way the environment has evolved over last 18 months for all corporates.
Right. So how has the adoption of business agility helped your company specifically in these, especially during these times?
So I think this has been the first time ever that you had to think absolutely on your feet. You had to think of answers which were never thought before, because the questions were new, and therefore you had to evolve answers that were new. You had to constantly make do with the resources that were available to you. So there was no really time to garner, greater amount of resources, nor you had flexibility of time. I mean, almost every time we say that we will change something, we very conveniently put a 4-quarter deadline or 6-quarter deadline and say that, okay, if you have to go from point A to point B in organization, this is what we'll achieve over 18 months or 24 months. And if you are really aggressive, maybe 6 months. But here you have to change overnight. You have to really think answers tonight or tomorrow morning, and you didn't have time beyond that. Therefore, the context of agility and how it played out has determined who are the winners in this environment, which has been, from a humanitarian standpoint, one of the most unfortunate incidents of our times. But it can get further bad news if it impacts the livelihood of people, it impacts operation, it impacts economic growth, and so on and so forth. So the organizations that have been able to get to a very smart, quick, here and now answer have really come out well. And for us, it has been a combination of factors. I think very specifically, as I mentioned, I think some of the BCP thinking for all of us, not just for Wipro, but I'm sure for every company on this planet Earth, had never thought about a situation like this, because of all our disaster recovery always relied that if location A went down, location B will go up. Because it was always thought in terms of telecom connectivity, it was thought in terms of rains and floods and situation like that, and it was almost inconceivable that you would have floods in Chennai at the same time you will have it in Houston, or you will at the same time you will have it in Singapore. So we always thought, saying if something somewhere goes wrong, it's very local, and how do I therefore distribute that workload, problem, response time, everything on rest of the location, and it will work fine. For us, as much as anybody else, we very quickly realized that no, everything is shut. So then what do you do? So I think for us, what worked, and I'll give you a couple of things that work. I think we all came together very quickly. I think we were as a CXO team meeting every day invariably for an hour, thinking through what we need to take a call today on and move forward. We left bureaucracy, you know, all sorts of it, absolutely out of any possible intervention it could cause and delay us. From day one, we said, you know, don't worry about budget. You know, let's go ahead. We know you can't spend beyond a particular amount if you were to want to do this. If you get in that point in time in terms of, you know, send me a rationale and ROI and budget approvals, then things are not going to, in those cases, you have to take a smart call on what could it effectively cost and let me move ahead. And lastly, I think our technology investments, infrastructure clearly help. For example, we were the first company in India and arguably Asia, I don't know factually, to come out with our results on 15th of April, of 2020, when and that was our original results publication date. There was no change, and that was possible because we found very quickly that our backbone was agile to and nimble enough to respond to this.
In what ways do you expect Oracle ERP Cloud that you are deploying now to help you meet strategic business objectives?
Sure. So, Anupama, we work with cloud providers of stature of all the big names, including with some of the solutions of Oracle, which Oracle offers. Specifically, within Oracle platform, the one that has worked really well for us is the one on the planning and management tool, which we implemented about 2 years back. And that came very, very handy for us to work through our planning activity for over last 3 years and specifically in this time. Other is the consolidation tool that we use from Oracle, which is around we operate in 100 plus subsidiaries, and we declare our results among the first in the country, not always first, but certainly among the top three. The first three results you would see would be from one of them, could be from Wipro. And these subsidiaries are spread across 57 countries. So consolidation is unique challenge by itself, but we have worked very closely over the years with Oracle to fix a consolidation platform which has worked wonderfully for us.
My final question, what would be your advice to business leaders for achieving the successful digital transformation? You told us about your journey and what could they learn from it?
You know, my advice would be two or three. One is we tend to follow our instinct as a CFO and almost every time get into ROI, business case, cost benefit analysis around technology. I think that's not the most optimal use of the capability that a CFO brings to the problem. The moment you take that lens away and then you ask yourself, what is my art of possible? With this technology, what can I achieve? And a CFO function by design is the closest to numbers, but it's also closest to business, and its ability to think through what technology can do for your organization is far better, I would think, than many other people in the organization, because even the information technology function within large organization, you know, they are not so close to business as the finance function is normally. So first advice is think with a lens of art of possible. And not with a traditional sense of ROI, you know, that works well when you are trying to install a factory or getting a big capex done. But most of the time on IT side, it is around art of possible. Second is, ask yourself always that whether doing something will bring the center of gravity for a large organization down. And that is very important for your success in a digital transformation. If you use technology to put all the controls that you never could put manually, you know, I can tell you it's going to fail. Not that controls are not important, but you have to think them through. You have to make sure that they are sufficient, adequate, and what you need. And by and large, you are making things easy for yourself. I mean, you would have heard most apps work on a four-click principle that you should be able to get your transaction done not more than in four click. And similarly, when you're looking at a digital transformation internally, you have to think like that and say, how do I make it easy? Lastly, remain resilient. I think digital transformation of a large enterprise is not an easy task. There will be times where you will raise your hand in the air and really wonder why you started a particular project, because if you are sponsor and it's taking two more quarters than you thought it would, or three more quarters, and everybody is looking at you with an expectation that when it will get delivered, it will sometimes test you, or most times it will test you. But remain resilient and see through it on the other side. I'm sure you would find that you are much better placed, because no advancements have happened without a little bit of teething issues, and no advancement ever has happened without a technological intervention. And we over always estimate in terms of how much you can do with your Excel and how much you can do with your SOPs and how much you can do with your governance. Technology is a true enabler. Lastly, I will leave one other thought. I think finance professionals in the same vein as point of art of possible have to really embrace technology far more closely, and by that not remain in our comfort zone of accounting and finance and investments, but really understand technology for technology's sake. Unless you understand technology, you won't get the best of what technology has to offer. So especially if you are somebody who passed your chartered accountancy or similar courses 20 years back, and therefore probably at a point where you are senior enough, but you have not invested sufficient time in technology, I would deeply encourage people to take a course on technology every year and challenge yourself with that. And it doesn't matter if you are the worst programmer in Python, but you would understand technology much with a very different lens than what would be otherwise. So I would encourage that.
Right. Thank you very much for sharing those very interesting thoughts. And thank you very much for your time. It was a very interesting interview. Thank you.
Thank you, Anupama. And thank you again for having me. Bye-bye.